And she said, we must get together. But I knew it'd never be arranged. Then she handed me $20 for a $2.50 fare. She said, Harry, keep the change.
Hi, I'm Councilman Mark Cuthbertson, and I am really excited to be here at the Harry Chapin Rainbow Stage to film a segment to talk about some really, really exciting upcoming events. And I'm here with Bill Ayres, who is the co-founder with Harry Chapin of Why Hunger. In the town of Huntington this year and in New York State, we're celebrating two very, very exciting anniversaries. First, our Huntington Arts Festival is celebrating its 50th anniversary this year. So that's why we're here at the Harry Chapin Rainbow Stage, where all these terrific summer events happen. Our Arts Council for these many years has created a just terrific summer program that is a highlight for so many people of cultural and entertainment works. But we want to talk to Bill because we're here at the Chapin Rainbow Stage, but there are some other things and anniversaries we want to talk about. And one is the anniversary of your group, of which you are the co-founder, Why Hunger, that you started with Harry Chapin. But first, Bill, I know you, I know your reputation, but so many of our residents in the town don't know you. Tell me a little bit more about your really vast and different background.
Well, I've been in Huntington for 36 years, living in Huntington Station for 36 years with my wife and children and now granddaughter. And Harry and I met each other in 1973. I was doing a network radio show for ABC called On This Rock, and I would interview rock and roll musicians and talk about their music and their values and their experience. And Harry said, wow, that was good. Come to my house for dinner. And that's how we started. And I've been in radio. I started actually in radio in 1968. It sounds like ancient history.
Right.
At WGSM, doing a couple of radio shows.
Which
there.
Which was locally here?
Yeah, right in Huntington.
Right.
Absolutely.
Right.
So my radio roots are in Huntington. But I've been on WPLJ since 1973. And I also have done a midnight show. It's the 40th anniversary of that show, the Bill Ayres show. It's on every Sunday night at midnight. And I've been doing it every Sunday night and talking to people about the issues that are important in their lives. So it's not the social justice work that I do normally. It's about life. And I also do another show called Community Connections, talking about with people who are doing something really good in the community. So that's part of my background. I was also a Roman Catholic priest for 13 years, right across the island in Babylon.
Which parish?
St. Joseph's.
Wow.
And then after that in Seaford for a while. I also ran the Dawson television station and did a lot of work with the Cablevision way back when.
So let me ask you, the name of your group, Why Hunger, obviously it's well known, but for you as a social justice issue, why hunger? Why did you pick hunger as really a signature part of what you're doing?
A little bit before the time when I met Harry, I was doing a series of television programs for one of the stations in New York, and I was interviewing third world leaders, including some fairly famous ones. But it was just talking heads, and I wanted to get some visuals, so I went up to Mary Knoll, which was a missionary, Catholic missionary order, and they had all kinds of footage of starving children. And I sat and watched this for about 3 hours. I thought my head would explode. And I came out, sat in the car and cried and said, I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I should do something about this. I had no clue what it was. And a month later, I met Harry. And I did a show with him and he loved it, invited me for dinner. And I said to him, you know, the concert for Bangladesh had happened the year before. And I said, why don't we do a concert for the Sahelian region of Africa, that part right under the Sahara Desert, where there was about 14 million people in danger of starvation. And he said, yes. And we actually tried to do it with the UN, it didn't work out. And we realized that the answer was not doing an event, it was making a commitment. So he and I made a commitment to spend the rest of our lives fighting hunger and poverty.
A facet of it that I don't think, certainly I wouldn't have imagined a number of years ago, and you might not have, is the issue of sustainability and growing food again, and where we look to big agricultural companies to produce food. Now we're going in an opposite trend, knowing what the health benefits of that are and what it does to our community, maybe what it does for our immunity systems in the case of locally grown honey and things like that. But a facet that maybe you never would have thought at the time when you started on this issue that this would evolve.
Tom Chapin, who will be on this stage for that concert on the 27th, has a whole album about food issues. And he has this great song that says, locally grown and locally eaten is locally good for us all. I mean, it just says it, doesn't it?
It certainly does.
And so we've always been very supportive of our farmers out here, out east, and over in New Jersey, and up the Hudson River, and trying to get locally produced food into our supermarkets and into the stomachs of our people. Very, very important.
Terrific. You started talking about the concert that the Arts Council is sponsoring here to celebrate its 50th anniversary. Who else we're going to have there? I know you said Tom is going to be there.
Tom
Sandy,
will be there.
Harry's wife.
Yes, and Steve Chapin and the Harry Chapin Band will be there. Jen Chapin will be there, her band, and Tom Chapin and his band. It's going to be a great evening, absolutely great evening.
And we had them here several years ago, and it
was, I was here. There was
packed, and it was a very,
very, of people.
Very special night, and I think there's no doubt that we will, given everything else, that it will be another very, very special and memorable night in the
town. So, folks, come early. Come early, because there's going to be a lot of people there.
That nice green space that we're looking at out there, that'll be taken very, very quickly. But we luckily, there's plenty of seating that we can accommodate. And that night, we're going to unveil a new marquee for this stage, because a lot of people, it's easy to forget that it's the Harry Chapin Rainbow Stage, and a new marquee that will memorialize that, and we'll do that as a part of the celebration that night. So something really to look forward
Absolutely.
To.
Absolutely.
So let's talk a little bit more about your friend Harry. Obviously, he was very much on the scene here in Huntington, left us so tragically short, so many talents, so many things that might have been that weren't. But what brought him to the town of Huntington?
Well, it's really interesting. Tom Chapin's TV show, in a way, Make-A-Wish, Harry did the music for that. And this was before he became famous. And so for the first time, he and Sandy had some money to buy a house. So without the Make-A-Wish money, they wouldn't have bought the house up in the Bay. And they decided to come to Huntington. But when he came to Huntington, he got involved, and not just in hunger, but as you know, the Performing Arts Foundation in Huntington, and he was involved with dance, with music, with education. He was involved in Huntington. He was a Huntington guy, even though he only lived here about 10 years.
Just at the end, we want to recap a little bit here about this exciting event that we're going to have here on June 27th. At the Chapin Rainbow Stage. It's going to be an exciting concert. We've talked about the members of the Chapin family who are going to be here. But there are, in the spirit of Harry Chapin, there are going to be some fundraising things going on. One of which is we're partnering with Long Island Cares. And Bill, maybe tell us about that terrific organization and what we're doing that night.
Yes. We started Long Island Cares back in the early 80s, and it has become one of the very best food banks in the whole country. Paul Pachter, who runs it, will be here that night, has done a great job. There's a wonderful team of people out there. And they're not just giving out food. They work with about 500 or 600 grassroots organizations and get food to them. But they also have they have an office right here in Huntington Station. It's right down the block from where I live, actually.
Right.
And it's a social service agency where they help people get connected to jobs and health care and child care and housing and all kinds of things. They have a special program for veterans, getting jobs for veterans. They have another place in Lindenhurst and another one in Freeport. So they're trying to reach the whole person. And Harry and I started off believing that the root cause of hunger is poverty. Root cause of poverty is powerlessness. So the answer is not simply to feed people. That's the model that's been taken up by thousands of food pantries and soup kitchens. But Long Island Cares is different. They're not just giving people food, but they're helping people take the next step out of poverty. That's one of the reasons why I like them so much, even though, I mean, I'm prejudiced because we helped to found them. But, you know, if they weren't doing a great job, I'd be blowing the whistle, but they're doing a great job. So folks, you ought to donate to Long Island Cares, now the Harry Chapin Food Bank. Bring some food, bring some money. And this was one of the last things that Harry got started before he died.
So that night we're asking people to bring a non-perishable food item or many non-perishable food items. We've also coined a very corny phrase, we want your loose change so Harry can keep the change. And I also, and correct me if I'm wrong, when it comes to Long Island Cares, I think at least the Huntington Station venue, there are volunteer opportunities
there. Yes, there are.
So if people come and want to volunteer, and we know young people nowadays, the community service is a part of their college applications, it's a part of their college work, so there are opportunities there that they can...
And also in Haupog, which is their main office, they have people sorting food, they all kinds of places that where right. people can help.
Speaking of Long Island Cares and their locations, correct me if I'm wrong, someone can go to the Huntington Station location or the Haupog location, and there are volunteer opportunities.
Yeah, there's all kinds of volunteer operations. And another thing people can do is do their own food drive. So there's lots of possibilities here. And I love this Harry Keep the Change notion, because that comes from Harry's great song, Taxi. Harry Keep the Change was the line from there. And here, in a sense, the change is going to go to help hungry people.
Right. That's terrific. Well, it has been a real, real pleasure. You are an icon in our community, someone who's done so many good things, and there are so many good things ahead of you, including these upcoming events. So it's been a pleasure.
It's been wonderful to live in Huntington all these years. It's a great place to live, and it's a great place to bring my granddaughter to this beautiful park.
Yeah, and a great place to enjoy a concert.
Yes.
Thank you.
Peace.
Drive a princess blind. There's a wild man wizard that's hiding in me, illuminating my mind.